Hey everybody, this is Brenda from KBW Bargains, and I hope you had a happy Thanksgiving. We had a happy Thanksgiving with the family, but on Black Friday, instead of going to your normal retail stores, we went to the Goodwill bins in Portland by the airport, and I wanted to share the haul that we came back with and point out some of the highlights. But first, I wanted to break it down to you for the Goodwill bins in Portland. We had, our total came to $72.18. We bought 45 items, which averages $1.60 per item. And we did get some boots that were heavier, but we also got some lightweight, it'll be summer hiking apparel. So it kind of averages out. And so we do it per item and it came to $1.60. So what I wanted to start with is to show you, cause some, got something in my eye. But our items, there are some that have good sell-through rate, and those are the ones we all like to pick up. Then there's items that have almost a good sell-through rate, but they have a good pricing on them. So I'll wait for them to sell to get that higher price. Then there's items that you personally have, maybe have a good sell-through rate personally, because when you buy it, you can sell it. Whether it sells good on the site or not, you've had great success picking them up and selling them and have no problem. Now, and I have some of those that I wanted to share. So the first item is Sorel boots. And Sorel boots have always done well for us. And what we don't sell on eBay or other platforms, we will sell locally. And so we have no problem selling these. But Sorels do well for us. I think they do well for everybody. And these are in really nice conditions. This didn't have a particular name to them. Usually it'll show up in here. But inside, I put down the numbers that come on. These are women's, and I put down the item number. And it came up with 20 listed, 6 sold, which I'm not too worried about because Sorels, we sell a lot of. There's a fair share on the market, and they go for good money, $40 to $60 listed and sold. And our, you know, winter is not quite here yet for us in the Pacific Northwest. It is cold, but it's still not snowing down in the lower levels for us. And so not that it's not snowing where you're at, but like I said, we can sell these locally also. But I will sell mine for $45 just because, you know, there is quite a few on the market, but like I said, there was only 20 of this particular style and code. And when you're doing boots, these are used, but I can tell they are in excellent condition, but still, even in good condition, I will check. Make sure you bend the soles, make sure they're not cracking, because a lot of the rubber can get brittle, especially right up in here. Check that. If it has leather, which this doesn't have leather, this is a ripstop canvas material. It's very nice, durable. But make sure you're checking leather and make sure you've got where the seams are. Make sure that they're not separating, because these are really, I mean, if you can see that, that's in really nice condition, nice coloring. And so I will do well on those. Now, the other item I have is for boots are Uggs. And I wish this was in my size. This is a size 7. And these, if you can see, those are in clear on the bottoms. I don't have to do much cleaning. And these are the Rianne. I will post everything off to the side, but Rianne. And again, Uggs is kind of like Sorel's, very good. There's starting to get some more on the market. Sell through is always good. I've never had a problem selling Uggs. They sell great for me. But these went for this particular style went for $35 to $55. So I'll list mine for about $39, kind of on the lower end of the market, just because I want to get some good sales before Christmas. Next item is a 20, where did I put that item? 20X. This still had the Goodwill tag that wouldn't sell at the Goodwill store. But this is a 20X, that's what it's just called, 20X. It's by Wrangler, it's a Western shirt. Most of them are Western shirts. And I really like this because it has some good stud detailing. It's a pearl snap, it is women's. And sometimes I have a hard time telling between men and women's because there are some box. But this was nice because it has the dart on the breast, which makes it obvious for women's fitting right there. It's also fitted in the back, but it is a really nice and unique pattern. I had a really hard time because I thought that was dirty, but it has a beautiful, nice pattern to it. It's nice and clean. I couldn't find any, there's nothing wrong with it. I've sold 20X before, but not in women's. I've sold it in men's and had no problems. Sold it quite fast. And so because it's a Western brand, Western Pearl Snap, that always goes well for me here. And then especially in this area, Pacific Northwest, Kevin's home. I can hear him coming up the stairs. And so I picked that up, no problem. Like I said, I haven't sold women's. But for the women's, and this is a extra large. Extra large. So I narrowed it down to those filters and it came up with 33 listed, 12 sold. Like I said, there's not that much, but it went for a good, pretty good price, $17 to $29. I'll list mine for $24. And I don't think I have any problem selling that. Long sleeve, Western Pearl Snap. I can't go wrong with that. The next item is can lighting. Kevin picked this up. I didn't see it because he always goes to the bins right when they come out. But this is can lighting conversion kit. I would assume somebody probably bought this for their house and bought too many of them and just put them because they are brand new. I looked and checked in here, even though it's rattling. I did check in there. They are wrapped. And this particular model, I looked it up, and there is more sold than listed, so I was happy with that. And they went for good money. They went for $30 to $45. The only downside was it, and I never understand why certain items have free shipping on all the items, and some sell with shipping. But this, the majority had free shipping, which I don't do free shipping on my store, so I'll list it on the lower end and add shipping. So I'll probably do it for $39 plus shipping. This is 3 pounds. It'll go as 3 pounds, so it'll be $11.50 for the shipping. The next item I have is a Minion piggy bank. And I've never sold him before. This is Stuart. I had to look him up because I wasn't sure. I sold the one with the two eyes, which is either Kevin or Dave. And I sold it pretty fast when I got it because, and this is ceramic. Ceramic key bank banks, piggy banks that have this and that still have this do well. And he has no chips, tears. He has no rips, chips, or anything defective on it except for some glue where it looks like something sticky. So I'll just get that off with a magic eraser. It doesn't have a year that it was in, but it's got some good information on the back. And I'm not sure how big he's not very big. But I sold the last one, I can't believe, $17 or $19. I had him listed for $22, took offers. So I'll probably do the same thing with him. I'll list him for about $22 and then take offers, leave room for offers. But the last one I had went pretty fast. I don't know if Minions is still hot right now, but I thought I can't pass him up. The next item is a special blend. With snow pants, I've been doing great with snow pants. And anytime I can find them, I get them because I've been selling them like crazy right now. And this is Special Blend. I believe it's something with Burton. It's part of Burton Style or Burton Company. But I do well with snow pants. I pick them up. And I like to pick up different brands because lately I've been just picking up REI and Columbia. So I like to pick up a different name. And that is in good quality. It doesn't have any rips, tears, or holes. It doesn't have any stains. And so I'll be able to sell that easily, I believe, for $39. But the range is $29 to $49. They've been going through sell-through rate. It's not at 100%, but we're just coming into winter, so I believe that that will go up as we go along. And the next item is, I would have kept it for myself, but I wanted to point this out because this is absolutely, I love the color, I love the design. Anything that has, I think it's Tabasque, but if anything handmade in Peru, wow. So you know, can you guess what it's gonna be? What the material is gonna be? It is alpaca and wool and some acrylic in there. But this feels, it's really soft, but it's a small. I don't like to pick up smalls, but I couldn't pass it up. When you've got that coloring and that design and the pattern on it, I'll take my chances. And when I looked it up, anything you can get with really any material besides cotton, polyester, and nylon, you can price it a little bit higher. I had Algora, is that the rabbit fur or the rabbit blend? That sold really well for me. I've had alpaca, it does well for me, or lamb's wool, virgin wool, all that will do well. And this one, the sell-through rate wasn't as high, but we're coming into the winter, that might go a little bit better. But the items that did sell sold for $29 to $65. And it did. The average was a little bit higher. The average was about $40. I'll sell mine for about $39 and leave room for offers. But yeah, anytime you can get stuff with a different material besides the basic cotton, nylon, polyester, look it up. They'll go well for you. And the next item is, now this is an item that doesn't have a good sell-through rate, but it did well for me. I bought it and I sold it quickly, so I thought I'd try it again. I got tons of offers. I got tons of opportunities to sell offers, and it was like that on all three platforms. It is this buckle belt. Never heard of it, never seen it, but there was a lot of them with comic characters. They're popular with the comic, like Pokemon, Batman, all the Marvels, and it says Suicide Squad. It went originally for $24.98. It still has the tag on the back, so I'm not sure if it's even been bought or worn. But this did well for me, so I thought I'd try it again. I only sold the last one, though, I believe for $15. But I left room, because I try to set my prices to leave room for offers. And I believe I had it for like $19, and I went down to $15. And I was happy with that sale. Anytime I can sell something fast, I'm willing to reduce it a little bit. Now the next item is, I'll have to flip my paper, shaky shaky there, flip this over. I have a Sherpa jacket. This is by Columbia. I sell a lot of Columbia because I have an overabundance in my area. Columbia REI, because the Northwest, Pacific Northwest is known for hiking and outdoor wear. And we have a lot of the companies based here, so we get a lot of it in our Goodwill bins. But this is a Sherpa full zip jacket. And I really like this because I like to pick up something different other than the basic fleece, because I have a lot of fleece jackets. But this is Sherpa. It's a little bit heavier. It's nice and warm. I did try it on. It's an extra large, but this is a good size. And it's got some nice detailing with the pocket in the front, the pockets on the side. Has no rips, tears, or holes. I'm not a big fan of light material like this, whether it would be a light beige or a white or an off-white, because I always find a spot on it when I go to take pictures. But this, I took my camera and I looked it over, and there is no spots on it, so I'm really happy with that. But this will go well for me, because I've sold a couple of these and they've sold right off the bat. And I've had other things other than Sherpa, other than this was a shirt. And I thought, wow, that's gonna be really hot to wear if you can't unzip it or anything. But this had 132, I broke it down to the style and the style and the size, and also the condition it was used. So I broke it down to that. And there was 132 listed, 82 sold. And the selling price and the sold price was worth about $22 to $39. I'll set mine at $26, the lower end. And everything I do is with shipping. And I think this will go quite fast for me, so I'm happy with that. And that was one of the reasons I bought it, because this item I have sold in the past with no problem, so I felt confident picking it up. And the next item is a Euro bag. This was a bag, because I pick up a lot of hiking bags. I don't do designer purses or anything like that. So most of mine are hiking travel bags, purses. And this was Eurosport. I thought I've seen this brand before. It looks like it has leather on the front here, and it's a green canvas. It is an adjustable strap, a crossbody. But this has done well for me. This type of bag has done well for me. Now this brand, I am new to it, so I don't know, but I got some numbers for you. But it's got three good compartments. It looks like, I would say travel, because this looks like it's padded right here in this area, right here. So like you can put a tablet or a small laptop, a mini laptop. And it's just, it's good for travel. I see a lot of that with that. And I would say this was a men's, because when I looked it up, it didn't have women's purses. I put in this name and it all came up with men's. And when I looked it up, I didn't find this exact same one, but what was similar to it were slingbacks that you can get, and a lot of men wear those. So I figured I'll put it closer to this. But this item in backpacks, or it looks like backpacks, suitcases, tote bags, mostly for travel, do well. And this, the sell-through rate, like I said, I couldn't find this exact one, but in that, in the similar bags like this, it went for $24 to $49. So I'll price mine about $34, leave some wiggle room for some offers. But yeah, here is a new brand. I will definitely pick this up, and I am excited to see how it's gonna sell, because it's exactly right up what I sell, what I have in my store. And it had some good prices, so when you can look that up. The next item is National Park Service. Anytime I can pick up items for that has employee uniforms, the only uniforms you can't pick up, and I found out, were anything with the delivery service. So if like USPS, FedEx, or UPS, I have had those or taken off, removed from eBay. Now the other sites, I have not had any warning on them, but on eBay you cannot do that. But employee shirts for fast food, for retail, I've had no problem with. And I have sold, I've never sold National Park Service, but I've sold National Forest Service. And I would assume it's the same. But these are, this one's a button up long sleeve. And it feels, this one feels like a heavier canvas. Then I have the two lighter short sleeve, probably for summer, with the Park Service somewhere right there. And these have a good sell-through rate. These were actually 16 listed, 18 sold. 16 listed, 18 sold. And they were listed and they were all used. And they sold for between $19 and $39, because there were some that were on bids. That's fine. But the average was about $29. I'll sell mine for $34, like I say, because it has such a good sell-through rate. I'll leave myself some wiggle room for offers on that. But if, like I said, because I have sold fast food, sells fast, McDonald's, Burger King, Subway, Pizza Hut, Taco Bell. I've sold that, and I've always sold it real fast. So people either take it for themselves or they're buying them for their employment. The other one is retail. We sell a lot of Walmart. Walmart, the vest, sold those. It's a grocery store, but I just got done selling really quickly Safeway t-shirts and a hat, and they weren't all to the same person. So if that's good. So if you see them, don't go, oh, who's going to buy that? The person working there will buy that. My last item, and I'm hoping you guys can help me. So as I go through the bins, I try to, because I've been, you know, we've been going for about 5 years now, and I don't like to wear gloves, and everybody goes, ew, but that's the way I can feel the material. And this material on this item felt, it's really soft, it's really nice, it's a soft knit cotton. But you can just tell the quality when you're going through the bins. You can tell the difference between linen and cotton, between polyester and acrylic. So that's why I like to not wear gloves. And this one, I do not sell, let me put this out, I do not sell designer brands of anything. Designer sunglasses, purses, bags, handbags, or any type of clothing. But when I came across this, I was wondering, why didn't it get picked up? Because you always wonder that. But here is the crest. It is Gucci. Gucci, made in Italy. And it is a large, it's a good size, but I'm not sure if it's because of the Arab or Italians. It does have just a small little string here, which I will take care of. But this, it looks more like a medium to me. But when I looked this up, I thought, oh, polo, even though it's Gucci, it can't be that much. Okay, this is probably why I don't do designer, because I don't know a whole lot about this. But they were going for hundreds of dollars for just a plain polo shirt. I'm very nervous, and that's why I'm like, help, Gucci. And so I did some research, and this is a crest, but this is from the 1950s. It's one of their originals, but you know, they can put the crest on new stuff. So, but I am thinking it's vintage, and it's just the nicest quality. I see why designers. But I love the coloring around here, the stripe and there. It looks very polo, very ritzy. But this, I had to look up what it's made out. So it's just made out of cotton, but it's very, you know, well knit cotton. But when I looked up the washing on it, this is what kind of throws me, because it says not, I don't know, washing by water. I'm not sure what that's supposed to mean. It says do not bleach. And if you're gonna iron it, put it on medium at 155, is that 153? But it says dry clean only. So not to wash it in your wash machine or your dryer. But this one, I'm going to list the Gucci. I mean, it went anywhere from $126 to $200. There was one that was $250. And most of those ones were having the Gucci monogram all over print that were the higher priced ones. But this one, this exact same one, sold for $130. Those are crazy money to me. So I will be doing some more research on this before I list it. And I'll probably list it lower than the 130. I'll probably list it for about 99, maybe a little bit higher, but that's about what I'm thinking. But it's in excellent condition. It has no rips, tears, or holes other than a small string hanging from it. It's got no dirt or anything, so I don't need to go have it dry cleaned. And I'll be happy with that. So it's amazing what you'll find at the bins and what people will leave behind. And for someone to throw that in the bins, that's crazy to me. I would assume that it was, I don't know why they would even throw it away, actually. I have no idea. But that's why I wonder. I put a lot of skepticism when I find high quality stuff in the bins. Like, how did that get there? And I'll be doing my research on that. And I have, you know, that's only a small portion of what I got. We got, you know, almost 44 pounds of items, and the most of it is my bread and butters. And like I said, we live in the Pacific Northwest, where outdoor wear is abundant, and so there's a lot of Columbia, REI, Lands End, Eddie Bauer, and those items I sell every day, all the time, and for average money. But these were the highlights that I wanted to share with you in our haul, and I hope you enjoyed it. All right, see you next time.